At the end of our last vlog, we had just left the Shropshire Union and joined the Staffs and Worcester to continue our journey south. The southern section of the Staffs and Worcester Canal starts at Autherley near Wolverhampton and finishes at Stourport on Severn, a distance of about 25 miles. Here at Aldersley Junction, if you look to the left, you can see the archway that takes you to the flight of 21 locks climbing all the way to Wolverhampton. Not for us today. One thing that was quickly apparent to us was just how low the bridges were on the Staffs and Worcs. Here's Tettenhall Old Bridge as an example.
We just make it under with not much room to spare.
As water bypasses every canal lock, there is a need for a weir, or a bywash as it's called. Those on the Staffs and Worcester are very unusual and really attractive.
This is my view of Rob leaving Dimmensdale Lock.
And this is what it looked like from the tiller. The three locks at Bratch were designed by James Brindley and opened in 1772, originally as a staircase. Closer examination, however, will tell you that they have been redesigned and are now made up of three separate locks, albeit with a very, very short pound in between. This is the awe-inspiring sight of the vortex created as water enters the second chamber from the small pound in between. You will also notice the blue paint on top of the paddles, important in telling you which order they should be opened. It is remembered as blue before red is what the man said. Red before blue, that won't do. Needless to say, we were really pleased that there were volunteer lock keepers here that day. All along this section of canal, you see this sandstone, evidence of the significant engineering work that was required to create the cutting. At Stourport Junction, we can look left and see the start of the Stourbridge Canal.
On a boat in a lock is the last place we expected to bump into Ed Balls and Yvette Cooper. But I have to say, they were really friendly and allowed me to take their picture. I stopped short of asking him to perform Gangnam Style for us, though. The town has had a long association with the weaving industry. Since the 18th century, carpet weaving has become the main industry in Kidderminster, aided massively by the building of this canal.
Stourport on Severn has long been a busy inland port. Where the Staffs and Worcester Canal meets the River Severn, and today was no exception, and we sat in the dock for almost 2 hours, waiting to join the River Severn through these two staircase locks. Thank you. The squeals of delight from the fairground didn't tempt us. Joining the River Severn is all the excitement that we can handle at our age. We haven't been on a river for a long time, and we'd forgotten the experience of breadth and strength. We begin the next leg of our journey and look back to say goodbye to the Staffs and Worcester Canal.